Welcome back to Let's Play Amberstar. Blind, I am Amethyst Lunatari. We're headed over to the Dwarven Mines. Off screen, I rested up at the inn. I forgot to do that. So, just in case you guys are like, hey, you messed up, because all our points were down at their, you know, original values before we leveled up, so it's like we got injured, although we didn't. Go figure, but we're good now. And I waited till morning. So hopefully we can make it there without being nightfalling. Let's just go straight to Twin Lake. Whoop. Or more or less straight. Welcome to the Giant Eagle Airlines. Please make sure your trays are fastened into their secure position. Whatever the hell they say. Look, it's the old villa. Alright. So, from here. We are really close by at this point. So close by that we're actually here. This is what you have to do to get to this place. This is probably the only way here. Oh. We'll attack. Don't expect to be thrown into combat so quickly. But hey, what are you gonna do other than throw on some armor protection too? I need to find her the skull for armor protection 3. I'm just curious. Okay, yeah, we can cast more of them at this point. I guess we'll focus on this one. So some kind of variety of rat, obviously. Throw a fireball. Now I can cast 23 fireballs, and now I can't. Apparently, I can't fail a spell. I mean, it can be resisted, but I can cast it with no problem. I don't see a need to cast any of these things, at least not yet. Let's see how dangerous these things are. It might be just a cakewalk. Cave rats. So just a reminder, we are here to find the Dwarven Crown. And once we find the Dwarven Crown, we can head back to... Boom. We can head back to... Okay, I cast a spell. Where else can you find cave rats that cast spells? We can head back to Doras Mine. Well, he will pry out of the Dwarven Crown a piece of the Amberstar. I guess I'll throw another fireball. I don't know how tough these things are compared to other rats we faced. Did we get that on? I'm not even sure. Let's get weapons power 3. Missing a lot. And not doing damage when we hit. I got rid of one. Successful. Okay, we do have it on. Well, I guess we don't need our torch here either, as we can see. Okay, finally anti-magic, because they are casting spells, go figure. Attack this one. You assist. She's casting that spell. You can attack this one. (Clears Another fireball. Why not? Now, how's Griban doing? He's not down that much. I mean, maybe I'll just cast a healing 2 on him just so she does something. That K-Rat's gonna be done. Oh yeah, we hit him hard. Doing better now. I seem to be missing a lot more. Well, still missing now. Drobanir is missing left and right. Successful for Phantom Magic 3. Healing 2, successful. Drobanir. Oh, got hit by a lot of points. So, here. He has a healing 3 on him. Droba. Yeah, I instinctively... See, in Baldur's Gate, you can click on the portrait of the person, and here the cursor won't let you. Well, I was trying to do that. And other games like that as well. He's just gonna hang out. Let the thing come to him. You can hit that. You can hit that. Let's save fireballs and go to throwing sling stones. Some point I'll be able to get Trasric's attack up a little higher. Okay. One left. Doing no damage at all. Trasric resists the magic. Good to know. So it's sitting there casting spells at us, so we gotta move over and fight this thing. Don't flee, we want to kill you for experience and over the gold you might have shoved up your butt. They're down 10 points each. That's fine. What if I stun it to prevent it from leaving? How bad do we want its loot, right? Mud catapult. Oh good. You don't have to waste those spells. 16 experience. No gold. Makes sense. There's rations. Okay, so apparently now we've got some kind of... I guess that thing doesn't move unless we move? Oh no, it was moving slowly. Spiders, apparently. I haven't fought spiders for a little while. I'm probably gonna poison us, that kind of thing. I think they're gonna be harder than the rats. I'm gonna have him wait till they're all lined up. Healing 1 just says she has something to do, really. Gabanica's cave spiders. Cave rats and cave spiders. Satine hit twice? Ow. He's really good at languages. Just realized that. Human, gnome, and animal. Alright. Well, now we can cast two hailstorms. This is not even including because I've thrown some fireballs already. I'm going to throw a fireball. And heal Gribben. I used to say attempt to heal Gribben. Now I can actually heal Gribben. Unless he dies or something. I get stunned or something like that. From what I gather, I cannot fail spells. Which is awesome. What am I doing? Okay, we're all attacking, right? Everything's got somebody to do. Everybody's got something to do. But I want to say. Alright, one cave spider should be just about done. I wish Drobaneer was not doing no damage. We need a better weapon or something? Okay, yeah. One down. Yay! They're missing a lot, too. Okay, basically, Drobaneer is gonna solo this one spider, and everyone else is gonna be hitting the other spider. Another healing three. Nice, Drobaneer. Woo! Satine, she hits twice around. That's awesome. And she's a mage. Who would have thought it? Satine resists the magic. Go Satine. Alright, I'm sure we wanna... Yeah, he's okay. Do another healing three. I don't think he's damaged enough to do... to be casting healing four. Right, should be taking down one or two of them this round. So we're doing no damage. Good. Drobaneer, what I want to do, once Drobaneer kills that thing, he's not going to have an easy way to move over unless he moves over, but I'm going to move Silk here, so Drobaneer can go boop, boop, because this one on the end is undamaged, except for the fireballs he's been throwing. Okay, so he's moving, Trasric fireball. Eventually, there's going to be another spell that's our go-to spell, because we're going to be able to cast it more often. Which is probably going to be Ice Ball, but I want to wait till we can cast it and have more casts, basically. Then again, throwing Ice Ball would make combat shorter, right? You know, we'd do more damage. So, I don't know. Strong wind, this doesn't sound as effective as Fireball. But it does take more mana to cast, so go figure. Storm, Tornado, and Ice Ball. Good stuff. Alright, we're good. Okay, so you got this one down. Thank you. And another one down. Love that we're resisting. I love that anti-magic 3. We're doing well, so let's move him. We'll just have Griband stay there. Silk can attack from his new position. I'm just gonna have him throw sling stones now. Yeah, we're good. Things I hope they fix with Amber Moon. Once a monster moves, you don't have to reassign your attacks because you're still fighting that same monster. You know what I'm saying? So the character should continue attacking that monster until you tell them otherwise. Just because it moves, shouldn't be a reason to stop. I moved him. Okay. Alright. It might die this round. Yep. Germany didn't even get to move. All that tactical moving around and he didn't even get to hit it. He had to hit it. I meant not move. Well, at least we're getting 26 experience. And we're getting experience and we're getting food. We're not getting money, at least not yet. I don't know what's down there, but let's look at this. The sign says something in old runic letters. At least it's short, right? Since it's so short, maybe I can just look at it now. Let me just move this out of the way so I can compare. D. D O R A Doras? Who's Doras? Or Doras, maybe? A little apostrophe in this language, maybe? Maybe Doras. This kind of B thing. Sorry, guys. I usually do this off screen, but it's so short. And we might need to know it for something coming up. It's like a B. Doras. Oh, mine? There's an M. I. And then N, and then E. Yeah, Doras, or Doras Mine, or Doras Mine. Okay. Very good. Is this something? Is this a wall? Oh. I didn't mean to run out in the swamp. Okay, we're gonna fight spiders in the swamp. I hope we don't suffer environmental damage here as we're doing this. From the stuff we're standing in. I'm guessing we still have our protection. Yeah, we gotta still have our protections on. Points he could use a little. Swamp spider. Okay, so we got cave spider, and then we got swamp spider. And it's the typical German way of, you know, coming up with words. I find really interesting and cool in a way. Oh, the swamp spiders are easier than cave spiders, I guess. Basically taking two different words and mashing them together. Or maybe prefixes of different words. I'm just gonna wait here and hope the thing doesn't just throw spells at us. Which I'm guessing would be like web spells or poison spells. I'm gonna grab and just wait for now. But yeah, so swamp spider, you notice, is one word. Swamp spider. Which is the way they would write it in German. They would take the word for swamp and the word for spider and just put it into one big mashup word. Which is awesome, I like that. For some reason, I like it. Okay, we're all going. Gribben's waiting. I'm waiting. He's good. Does Droban need some healing? Not yet. He's okay. He's got a lot of hit points. Okay, we are hitting you from afar. I'm not really hitting or doing damage. Okay, he's moving over. Okay, so now... Attack. 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 Fireball. Okay, he's probably about to kill that one. You know what? They seem not... Yeah, just attack. Save the fireballs. He seems pretty... Pretty good. I mean, they seem... Pretty fragile compared to the cave spiders we just fought. So let's just hit him with melee and ranged. These have money? The swamp spiders have money, but the cave spiders have none. Is this some kind of a caste system? Are the swamp spiders like the 1%? They're the elite members of the spider society? Alright, let's get back into the damn dungeon. I didn't realize what I was looking at, that this was the swamp. So we're still outside. Oh, there's a magic mouth type thing. So let's save. Is there anything down here? No, we're back out again. And I don't like it kicks us right into the swamp area, too. Okay, because this represents the green grass. Alright. Alright, so we need... Hopefully nailed the answer to what he's saying. Noon has been here for a long time. Why are you disturbing my peace and quiet? Do we know why? Hopefully I wrote this down somewhere. Stand by, guys. Donner. Oh, it's called Doras Mine. Valley east of Twin Lake. Maybe... Oh, and there's the Kelvin thing. Okay, I can cross this out. That quest is complete. That's from the near the beginning of the game. Do we want to tell it Donner? Donner was not the correct answer. Okay, do we want to tell it Crown? Did Donner tell us the word? Crown was not the correct answer. Don't tell me it's something where we have to go and back to Donner's mind and say, hey, puzzle mouth thing. Amberstar? Well, that is why I'm bothering you, by the way. I'm disturbing your peace and quiet because Donner told me to come here, get the Dwarven Crown with a piece of the Amberstar on it. That is the answer. That is my answer. Why else would I be here? Because we have to destroy the great evil. What's his name? I don't remember his name offhand. We don't talk about him that much. Tarbos, right? Tarbos. We are here to get the piece of Amberstar to defeat Tarbos. No. Treasure. Secret. I wish I could just not have the animation prevent me from moving to the next thing. I'm on a quest. No. Either I forgot to write it down or we have not been granted this word. I mean, it could be one of these things. Hello? Artifact. No. Alright, hold on, guys. While I look back at my previous video to see if Donner told us the word to the puzzle mouth, I'll be back. Okay, got it. I should have known it would have something to do with the name of the mine. I didn't even remember. Bothor told us. Donner did not remember. I hate this all the time. Always seems to come up at the worst times. Right, Donner did not remember the name that what we were supposed to tell the puzzle mouth. And so he gave us a letter to give to Bothor, and then we gave it to Bothor in the Ilion. And Bothor told us it's the name of the mine backwards. So it's either Doras backwards or Doras Mine as one word backwards. I'm gonna guess it's just the one. Which actually does not answer his question. The name of the name of the mine backwards is not why we're here. Not why we're disturbing its peace and quiet. So, Doras, Sarod. As you know the word for opening, I will let you in. Thank you. Okay. As I have gotten in, I will save. Okay, old dwarf mine. Okay, now we're in a more traditional dungeon setting. Because there are some dungeons where you walk around out like that in an isometrical view. Alright, so we're starting off. We can actually go. Technically. We can go lower than that, but maybe not. Okay. Suddenly, a trapdoor opens beneath you, and, screaming wildly, you fall into the depths.